Philippine Vice President Lenny Robredo still pursuing unity talks with anti-administration forces, even as the deadline for the filing of candidacy nears. According to Senate Minority Leader Franklin Drilon, Robredo met with presidential and vice presidential aspirants, Senator Panfilo Lacson and Senate President Vicente Soto III on Sunday. But Drilon says no agreement was reached during the discussion. He notes the two camps are unlikely to settling on a deal. Drilon believes Robredo will eventually seek the presidency. As for Robredo's camp, it says the vice president is close to announcing her decision.
Naintindihan naman namin ka, Ellie. Malinaw naman na madami ng excited, di ba? Madami ng nag-aabang. Konting hintay na lang.
Let's give her some leeway. As I said, she is, you know, looking at the race, accountability, not wanting to lose. So let's give her time. But, you know, in my books, anyone who muddles through in this kind of decision making, she does not earn points with me. I'm sorry. Yun sa leadership studies, no? Decisiveness is very important.
The infighting continues within PDP Laban as the faction of Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi expels Senator Manny Pacquiao for abandoning the ruling party. That's after the Philippines' fighting senator filed his COC for president under the regional party PROMDI. PDP Laban Secretary General Melvin Matibag says such a move is not allowed under the party constitution and is a ground for automatic expulsion. He adds the executive committee has already approved a resolution outing Pacquiao. But Senator Coco Pimentel, son of one of the founders of PDP Laban, defended Pacquiao, citing the party's alliance with PROMDI, which he says is permitted under party rules. Pimentel also slammed the Cusi wing for raising an issue based on what he says is a figment of their imagination. The Commission on Elections is set to come out with a ruling on the PDP-Laban row in the coming months.
Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio playing coy after her father said she will run for president next year. President Rodrigo Duterte earlier revealed in an ambush interview that Sara would be running for his post alongside Senator Bongbo, who already filed his certificate of candidacy for vice president over the weekend. But Sara's camp is choosing not to comment on the matter.
So, claro po ito, Sara Go.
Sara Go.
Sara Go. Kailan po ang filing ni Mayor Sara? Kailan po siya magpa-file?
I really do not know. I do not have any idea at all.
Duterte's pronouncement comes even as the Davao mayor filed for her certificate of candidacy for re-election. Still, political experts say nothing is final until the deadline for substitutions on November 15. After all, the elder Duterte himself entered the 2016 presidential race at the last minute through substitution.
Hindi nakakagulat yung hanggang last minute. Baka magpapalit ng mga pangalan o kaya may lilitaw na pangalan. Kasi yung kalakaran ngayon sa mga eleksyon natin, ay si Presidente may kasalanan din dito, ay hindi sinisigurado kung sino ay tatakbo until the last minute. Eh, paliwanag niya sa akin noon eh. Siyempre, ba't niya sisiguraduhin? Mabuti yung hindi makapaghanda yung kalaban.
What's to be expected, I suppose, is a lot of substitutions. Hopefully, hindi ganun. Hopefully, hindi ganun. Sana, maging upfront sila. Nagagamit siya as a way of surprising opponents. No? So, medyo hindi siya patas na laro.
Alright, more senatorial aspirants filed their certificates of candidacy Sunday. Among them, former Senator Jingoy Estrada. Estrada ran in 2019 but did not make the Magic 12. He will again face off against his brother, JV Ejercito, who also filed his COC over the weekend.
Well, I wish both of us good luck. At siguro naman palagay ko, there are 12 seats that are being fought for. And I hope both of us will win.
But do you think, sir, it's morally acceptable, sir?
Well, why not? Both of us, I think both of us deserve to be there. Both of us, isa lang naman dugo na nananalaytay sa amin. Ang dugong para manilbihan sa ating mga kababayan.
Vic leader Samira Gutok also sealing her second senatorial bid. Gutok also ran in 2019 under the Liberal Party's Ocho Derecho slate but lost. For this election, she is running under the banner of Action Democratico.
I owe, and I will continue to publicly claim that I owe much of who I am as a political personality to Vice President Lenny and the Liberal Party. But Action Democratico reached out at a time ng pandemya, and Yorme being the location, yung Manila, ng almost 10 barangays that are from the southern Philippines. We got to work together on outreach program, humanitarian.
For the local elections, presidential son Sebastian Baste Duterte filed his certificate of candidacy for vice mayor of Davao City. This comes a day after his sister, Sara Duterte Carpio, filed her COC for the mayoral post. Another Duterte running in Davao is Paulo Duterte, who is running for re-election as 1st District Congressman.